Hello dear students, today in this video lecture we are going to study the most famous and popular poem of Maya Angelou, that is Still I Rise. Maya Angelou, she was an American poet and civil rights activist. She has published 7 autobiographies, 3 books of essays and several books on poetry. Initially, let us see an introduction to the poem. In this poem, the speaker is depicting the story of an oppressed person and how she overcomes her situation. Maya Angelou describes various situations of oppressions in terms of racism, criticism, and other personal obstacles in her own life and how she overcomes each one of them with pride and grace. Also, she is explaining the hardships she had to overcome, just like any other American African woman. Still I Rise is an inspiring and emotional poem that is based around Maya Angelou's personal experience as a black woman in America. It encourages to face every hardship in life. So now let us see the poem stanza by stanza. You may write me down in history with your bitter twisted lies. You may throw me in the very dirt, but still like dust I will rise. So now let us see what she is trying to tell in the first stanza. The first stanza of this poem begins with the injustice history done to the poor black people and how their popular image has been being manipulated, while the poet gives a powerful blow on the one hand to discrimination and slavery. On the other hand, she evokes a picture of hope that the flame God lit could never be extinguished by men. The poor downtrodden will rise and fight for their liberty. You try to bring us down and we again fly like dust in the air. So here there is a light touch of rebellion and a hard dose of defiance or protest in these lines. Now let us see the second stanza. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Cause I walk like I have got oil wells pumping in my living room. So here, the author is questioning the audience that why everyone is so much affected or arrogant if I am being bold and brave, being gloomy and sad because of my moods. The speaker walks with enormous self-confidence, as though she were rich enough to own the oil wells at home. Here, the phrase pumping in the living room denotes that everyone feels the author earned whatever she have without any hard work. And now she is enjoying sitting in the living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hopes springing high, still I will rise. Do you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries. So in the third and fourth stanza, she is telling the weather changes, tides changes, and spring of hope keeps flowing. Like this spring, I will rise. Here, she compares her life with sun and moon, just like every new day, new sun shines, and with every setting sun, a new moon comes. The author be also hopeful to rise again. The author is very sad and wants to know why others are sad because of her happiness and why they want her to be broken, shattered or unhappy. With bowed head and lowered eyes, as if she had committed a big crime. Not just from outside, people want her to be deserted from deep within her soul and wants to make her hurt and give pain and soul cry. Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard? 'Cause I love like I have got gold mines digging in my own backyard. The poet asks if the people who want her and her people, woman slaves, will not be offended by her pride. People really hate her free behavior and the way she lobs over adversities. The African American lob wholeheartedly like no one is richer than them and they have got gold mines in their backyard. You may shoot me with your words, you may cut me with your eyes, you may kill me with your hatefulness, but still like air I will rise. So in this sixth stanza, the poet continues and said, if you want to use your hateful words to destroy me, you can. Your hateful look cannot kill me or stop me because they will give me more energy to rise. Here she explains the gestures of the people which are not so good. People give her nasty looks, abuse her by their harsh words, and hate her. She tries to rise over these looks, words, and hatredness. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I have got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs? In this seventh stanza, she feels that people are upset from the fact that she is being smart and sexy in her own way. People are looking at her with surprise, as though she likes dancing and got diamonds. But the truth is, she has got none. Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I am a black ocean, leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise, I rise, I rise. So in this last few lines, now the poet is in real seriousness. She's showing her true tone as she moves her thoughts to the past. She remembers that it has always happened with her. The history has always been like this, where the whites always suppress the blacks. She feels painful while she studies her memories of the past, which have been brutal and unfair. But at the same time, she gathers all her energy and again gets bold in her words. She understands that no matter, she have to go through a lot, be it past or even present. She had risen in the past and she will do the same in the future as well. She is hopeful and could see a wonderful, clear and bright future lies ahead of her. She got this energy and boldness from her ancestors who had suffered a lot and gave her the lessons of bravery and survival. These strengthen her to rise against all these sufferings, since she is the one who will shape the future of many others like her. In the last few lines of the poem, the poet is comparing her present with the past. She knows that the old days of slavery may have ended, but the present scenario is also not good. The blacks are still not getting the respect and pride which they deserve, and in order to make the future better, a future better one for all the people suffering from this harassment, she has to remain strong and always fight against these oppressions. So this is about the beautiful poem called Still I Rise. This poem is about the black people versus white people, the superiority versus inferiority. So here the black people are fighting against the white people to get their rights. So this is about this poem called Still I Rise, which is written by Maya Angelou. Thank you.